Jimmy, can you break down the latest CPI numbers coming in for September?
Yeah, so we've got a bit of a sigh of relief with that reduction in inflation from 4% to 3.8%. And really what's interesting is when we look at many of those core measures that are showing some pretty significant deceleration, either you look at inflation excluding food and energy, or you look at some of the Bank of Canada's preferred measures, they all show some moderation. One of the themes for me is really the sectors that are tied to travel, so discretionary consumer spending. So you're talking travel tours, air transportation, or even the rental of vehicles, you're seeing disinflation, if not outright deflation. So this does tend to indicate that consumers are really cutting back on those expenses, and it's contributing to the disinflation we're seeing.
We've often talked about that 12 to 18 month lag effect. Are we just getting there now? Are we just starting to feel that now?
Yeah, I think, you know, we are now entering the zone where a monetary policy has its maximum effect. So those very first rate hikes of last year are now clearly showing their effect on the economy. We also saw how the Bank of Canada's Business Outlook Survey relayed the notion that either businesses or consumers are feeling the effect of interest rate hikes and are expecting those that tightening to be felt even further going in the months ahead. So that tells us that, you know, what the Bank of Canada has accomplished so far has not been in vain, and therefore it doesn't need to exaggerate the tightening at this point. We think it's going to be happy to stay on the sidelines at 5%.
So just to be clear, when you take a look at all of that data, those September CPI numbers, GDP numbers, you had mentioned the Bank of Canada Business Outlook Survey, does all of that equal a hold end of October from the Bank of Canada?
Yes, absolutely. And we've always kept the view that the data overall was showing that the Canadian economy was slowing down. We saw that in the GDP numbers and, you know, how GDP, to the surprise of many, contracted in the second quarter. The numbers for the third quarter are not looking particularly robust. We expect to see a positive number, but not, you know, not too much above zero. Even when we look at employment, the last data print was good, but when you exclude the gyrations we saw in the educational sector, you see that it's pretty sluggish, and employers are saying that there's plenty of job searchers out there, and they're no longer feeling the labor shortages to be as acute as they were. So that's actually something that's constructive in terms of wage developments going forward. So all those factors combined, I think, make a pretty strong case that with the tightening that remains in place, you know, we don't need to add to that, that there's a sufficient amount of tightening. And as people renew their mortgages going forward, you're going to see more needs to cut back on those expenditures.
Lastly, you had mentioned a slowing economy, and everyone is, of course, wondering whether or not we are headed for that soft landing. How do you see it?
I think the soft landing is more a concept that's relevant to the United States. Clearly, the United States, with the number we saw this morning, defies all expectations. It doesn't mean that downside risks are not in there, but clearly this is a situation where the economy is much more resilient than what most were expected. I think in the case of Canada, it's a very different situation. We have more debt, and also our mortgage system is such that people have to renew every 5 years or even less than that. So it is taking a toll on the economy. We're seeing that pretty clearly in all the components that are sensitive. If you look at, for the second quarter, consumer and residential investment as a contribution, that was negative. So you're seeing the impact, and all we know is that it will only get more intense because by the end of next year, about two-thirds of mortgage borrowers will have renewed at higher rates. So a much different situation. Thus, I think in Canada, we're talking more about a recession, a soft recession, but a recession nonetheless.